Yes, children. Now, after completing the table, let us see what are the questions which has to come in our mind. What products would the organism be able to take up for other activities? What are the products that the organism takes in, for example, photosynthesis? The products that the organism can take is glucose and oxygen and water also. Oxygen in limited amounts and rest of the oxygen is let out. And in respiration, carbon dioxide is not utilized by the organism, both plant, both in animals. In plants, the carbon dioxide is utilized for photosynthesis. But energy is utilized by both the organisms like plants and animals for its activities. What happens if harmful products are not removed from our body? What happens if harmful products are not removed from our body? Harmful products means nothing but poisonous products. Poisonous products will result in ill health, causing diseases, attracting infections. So it may hinder the life processes' proper activity. It may also slow down the life processes, which may not be good for us. We have already learned that different kinds of materials are produced through metabolic activities. What are the two metabolic activities that we already discussed? The anabolic activities and the catabolic activities. The anabolic activity is building up, catabolic activity is breaking down. What breaks down is respiration and what builds up is photosynthesis. So let us see what are the metabolic activities which give out the waste. Usually they give out nitrogenous waste along with salts and excess water and other several materials which are excess to our body. So what is excretion? Excretion in Latin, ex means out. In Latin, ex means out, crenere means shift. That means shifting out. Excretion means shifting out. So excretion is a word which is derived from which language? Latin. And what exactly does it mean? Ex means out, crenere means shift. Now let us see what is the excretion, what is the process of excretion that takes place in human beings. Human beings, excretion means first and foremost what comes to our mind is kidneys. Now let us see, many metabolic activities take place in our human body and it takes place in every cell and every part of our human body. Now our human body, if we have to have a proper the human body has to function normally, it has to have proper normal healthy activities taking place inside, then the ionic balance has to be maintained in our body. Ionic balance means homeostasis. What is meant by ionic balance? Homeostasis. If the question comes, what is homeostasis? Ionic balance in the maintained in the body is called homeostasis. If toxic wastes are produced and they are not released out or sent out of our body, then the ionic balance is disturbed. If it is disturbed, then what happens? Now, before that, let us see what are the waste products. The carbon dioxide, water, nitrogenous compounds, ammonia, urea, uric acid, bile pigments, excess salts, all these are poisonous. And all of these waste products of metabolism is ammonia. Ammonia is usually a little foul-smelling waste product which comes out through urine in our body. Now, let us see how does it happen. Our blood goes into the kidneys per day many number of times, hundreds and thousands of times the blood enters into our kidneys and it is filtered. Every time it is filtered, along with the water, dissolved in water, the ammonia waste, urea, uric acid, everything dissolved in water is removed from the blood and it is accumulated into the urinary bladder as urine and it is sent out. So let us see the process of urine formation and how the kidneys look like, where the kidneys are situated, how the kidneys are, how many kidneys are, and what exactly is its function. Everything we'll learn in our next topic. Before that, now let us try to answer the questions which are given in italics here. What are the substances present in blood? The substances which are present in the blood are nutrients, oxygen, carbon dioxide, waste products which are sent out from the cell. What are the substances present in the urine? Substances present in the urine are almost all the nitrogenous waste and extra water, excess water, and unnecessary elements and compounds. What are the substances present in both blood and urine? The substances which are present both in blood and urine are water. Water and some of the elements. Which substances are present above the normal limits both in the blood and urine? In blood and urine, above the normal nutrients are present. In blood, above the normal nutrients are present. In urine, above the normal waste products are present. What do you think a reading above normal limits indicates? Now let us see that in the next page, in the form of table it has been given, children. So once all of you check page number 76. In page number 76, two tables are given. Department of Biochemistry, report on plasma or serum blood analysis, and table 3, Department of Biochemistry, report on urine analysis. And what are these present in blood analysis? Let us see. The things which are present in blood: glucose, sodium, potassium, chlorides, urea, creatinine, uric acid, total cholesterol, triglycerides, calcium, phosphorus, bilirubin, total proteins, albumin. So these are the things which are present in the plasma or the serum of the blood that we give. Then report on urine analysis. What are the things which are present in urine? In urine, protein is present, creatinine is present, calcium, phosphorus, uric acid is present. Now let us see what are the common things which are present in both urine and blood. Protein is present both in urine and blood. Creatinine is present in both urine and blood. Calcium is also present in both urine and blood. Calcium is present only in urine. Phosphorus is present in both urine and blood. Uric acid is present only in both in urine and blood. Now let us see in electrolytes. Electrolytes: sodium, potassium, osmolality, glucose, chlorides, urea. Here also you notice that there are some common things which are present both in blood and urine also. Now in page number 77, let us see in page number 77, what are the materials needed to be removed from our body? What are the things need to be removed from our body? We need to remove uric acid. See in the table, children, you will understand. You need to remove uric acid, extra calcium, extra phosphorus, and then unnecessary things like chlorides, urea. These are the things we need to remove. From where do these materials be removed? Usually they will be removed from sweat, in the form of sweat, or in the form of urine. What are the organs that separate excretory materials? Kidneys are the organs which separate the excretory materials. Why do you think the body must remove the waste products? Waste products have to be removed, otherwise the body activities will slow down and the body will fall sick. So to overcome this, we need to compulsorily remove the waste from the body. Now let us see. In page number 77, there is a lab activity in page number 77. Excretory system in human beings. Now, I don't want you to remove one kidney, but if you notice, goat kidney is also similar looking to human kidney except in its size. So if you get a chance to observe goat kidney, ask your parent when they go to the butcher shop to get one goat kidney and then cut it in half. How do you cut it? For example, let us see.
let us see how you cut it. See, this is how you need to cut the goat's kidney.
That means this area you need to cut and make it into half. Then what do you understand? Outside the outer peripheral and pelvis of it is light colored and middle of it is very dark colored. The periphery is light colored and middle of it is very dark colored. What is the shape of the kidney? See this, suddenly if I show you only this picture, what does it look like? You will say it looks like a bean. So bean shape, what is the shape of the kidney? It is bean shape. What is its color? Reddish brown in color. You can notice that it is reddish brown in color. Then what is the color of the kidney? Reddish brown. Then let us see once again. Let us see, children. One second, children. Okay, now let us see the lab activity. What are the questions that you need to answer after cutting it? Do you find any attachments on upper portion of the kidney? Upper portion of the kidney, do you find any attachments? Two cap-like structures will be present, children. These two cap-like structures, let us see. Yeah. On top of this kidney, you find two cap-like structures. Those we call them as adrenal glands. Is the internal structure similar to figure 2? So let us see. This is figure 2. Is the internal structure similar to that? Yes, exactly. They are same. In the LS of kidney, where do you find dark brown color? In the middle. How many tubes are coming out from the kidney fissure? This is called kidney fissure. This is called kidney fissure. The white colored part is called kidney fissure. Through that, what are the two things which are coming out are renal vein and ureter. What goes inside the same thing is renal artery, children. So now let us see. In the next page, now let us see. Let me show you the diagrams again. In the next page, yeah, in page number 78, now let us learn more about kidney. How many kidneys are there in our body? There are two kidneys. Now once observe this picture here, where are they present? They are present on the dorsal side of the human body. Dorsal side, below your, very close to your lower spinal cord. Lower spinal cord, two kidneys are present. If you notice, one of the kidney is a little above the other kidney. One of the kidney is a little above. See, for example, if you notice, your right kidney is lower than the left kidney. If you notice, the right kidney is lower than the left kidney. And there are two things which are coming out of the kidneys and one which is going inside the kidney. So now let us learn more about it. What is the shape of the kidney? The shape of the kidney is bean shaped. If you notice rajma beans, exactly like that, it has to be multiplied 5 times, then it will be of the same shape. Bean shape, they are reddish brown in color. They are present in the abdominal cavity, attached to the dorsal body wall and beside the backbone, lower backbone. The right kidney is placed a little lower than the left kidney. Why is it placed like that? Slightly lower than the left kidney. Right kidney is placed slightly lower than the left kidney because in that place liver is present. That is because of the presence of liver. Then what is the size of the kidney? If you notice the highlighted portion, the size of the kidney is 10 into 6 into 4. 10 into 6 into 4. If you read page number 78, you will understand it thoroughly, children. Then now let us see what are the three things which enter and come out of the kidney. One goes inside the kidney, that is, let us see, the dorsal aorta, which we also call it as renal artery. Dorsal aorta enters into the kidney, which we call it as renal artery. Renal is always used for kidneys, remember, children. And posterior vena cava, that is renal vein, comes out of the kidney along with ureters. two ureters. See, left ureter and right ureter, they come out of the kidney. So what are the two things which come out of the kidney? Renal vein and ureter. What goes inside the kidney? Dorsal aorta or renal artery. And what happens to the uterus? Ureters. Ureters will open up into the urinary bladder. And if you notice this curve, the curve should be compulsorily maintained when you are drawing the ureters. The curve should be compulsorily maintained because it is entering into the urinary bladder obliquely. If you notice, it is entering obliquely. It is not going straight into the urinary bladder. Urinary bladder is elastic in nature and it collects all the urine, and once the urinary bladder collects a lot of urine, it will excrete it in the form of urination through urethra, or we call it as external opening. So tomorrow let us learn about the internal structure of kidney in detail, children. Thank you very much, and I expect you all to read these three pages, I mean four or five pages that I taught till now, thoroughly and be prepared. Write the answers for all the italicized questions which are mentioned, which I already discussed in our class. Thank you.